trick is completely impromptu, which means we can take the cards here and just give them a total mix up. All these cards getting completely shuffled. I can spread through the cards here and show you guys that there is no order to the cards. Everything is completely mixed up. So at this point, I would actually have the spectator shuffle the deck as well. But before I have them shuffle, I just have them name their favorite card. Let's say they say the Eight of Hearts, for example. I say, okay, perfect. Why is that? They just say, oh, it's a lucky number and I like hearts. I don't know. It could be any reason. But let's say they say the Eight of Hearts and I say, perfect. Go ahead and give the cards a nice riffle shuffle. So they go ahead and they riffle shuffle the cards the best that they can. And they can really push these cards together. They can really see that the cards are getting mixed up. There's no order to the cards or anything like that. So perfect. We can further shuffle the cards, but it doesn't really matter. All I want you guys to know is that the cards have no order to them or anything like that. But what's gonna happen in this trick is I just want the spectator to think of any number that they want to between 1 and 52. And for example, let's say they're thinking of 10. And if you think of 10, you're gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 cards, one at a time from the top. And then you're gonna take those cards and turn them over on top of the deck so that later, if we look through the cards, we can clearly see how many cards you counted, okay? But don't do 10, think of a random number and don't tell me what you're thinking of, so I don't wanna know. And I'm gonna hand you the deck and I want you to take the deck and place it behind your back just so that I can't even see how many cards you're counting, just in case you think I'm like keeping track or something. So one more thing before you start, I'll give you another option to choose from. Do you wanna start counting from the top of the deck or the bottom of the deck? Let's say they want to start from the top of the deck. So I say, perfect. Take the deck and actually just turn it over completely so that you'll now be starting from the top of the face down deck. Okay, perfect. So let's say they're thinking of a number. I have no idea what they're gonna do. Let's say they're secretly gonna count 17 cards to themselves, okay? So one at a time, 17 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And they're gonna take those cards and turn them over on top of the deck. Now they're gonna bring them over here, and that entire process was done completely silently. They're not even counting out loud. They're only doing it in their heads, okay? So we're gonna take a look here at the deck. You guys can see this is the random amount that they counted. I have no idea what it is at this point. I had no control over this. It was completely in their hands, yet they stopped right here at this exact card. And I'm just gonna leave it there in full view the entire time. Now, for the first time, I would just count how many cards they counted. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, great. So they counted 17 cards randomly. I had no idea they would do this. If they counted 18, it would have been a different card. 19 would have been a different card. But they stopped right here at this card. And remember, they named a random card in the beginning. Well, I asked them what their favorite card was. They said, I think, what was it? The Eight of Hearts. That's right. You counted any number, but somehow you landed exactly on your favorite card, the Eight of Hearts, and you could have stopped at literally any point in the deck that you wanted to. Any of these cards would have been a different outcome. So yeah, that is the trick, guys. Really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to stick around for the tutorial. All right, guys, so here's the tutorial for the trick that you just saw. So I really hope you guys like this any card at any number type effect. It's a really cool effect I came up with, and I cannot wait for you guys to learn how it's done. It's actually very, very easy to do. There's only one or two sleights that you really have to know how to do in order to do this trick, and they're pretty simple. This trick is almost entirely hands-off. You're actually giving the spectator the deck for the entire second half of the trick, so you only really have to do all the dirty work in the first half of the trick. So basically, this trick is impromptu, which means you really can do this with like a borrowed shuffled deck of cards. Just make sure you have a full deck of 52 cards, because what you're gonna do is you're gonna have the spectator name any card in the deck, and they can literally name any card. It doesn't matter what it is. So what I like to do is first just give the deck a nice overhand shuffle, and then I spread out the cards, all the cards like this, so I can see all of them like this. Now I'm just gonna have the spectator at this point name any card in the deck. They don't need to point, they don't need to tell me where it is, just have them name a card from the top of their head. In this case, we'll do the Ace of Spades because a lot of people name the Ace of Spades. What I'm gonna do is I'm very quickly, I'm gonna try and look for the Ace of Spades. So I'm gonna see, boom, it's right there. ace of spades. I'm gonna look for it as I square up the cards. So I'm looking for it, boom, I see ace of spades, and now I know it's in the lower half of the deck. As I ask them, you know, why did you choose that card? Is it a favorite card? I'm gonna spread through and find that ace of spades, and all I'm gonna do is cut two piles and leave that ace of spades on the top of the right-hand pile. So basically just split the deck where their thought of card is. So spread through the cards. When you find their thought of card, just leave it on the top here of the right-hand spread and then split the cards like this. And now you're gonna have the spectator give the cards a riffle shuffle. So when they give them a riffle shuffle, there's two things that can happen. One thing that can happen, they can shuffle the ace of spades here on the top by themselves, and then you wouldn't have to do any sleight of hand after that. So if this happens, if they shuffle the cards like this, then you spread them out and you just push them together, and you can even have them push it together. And there you go, the spectator has now controlled the ace of spades to the top for you. That's one option, but one other option that can happen is they can shuffle the cards and the ace of spades gets lost in the deck. At this point, you need to take control of the deck. You don't want them to push the cards together, so just say, here, look, I'll actually spread them out for you so you guys can really see that they're getting shuffled. You're gonna push them together a little bit, and as you go forward to spread them out, you're just gonna take a couple of cards from the top of the right-hand pile, literally just pull them out and put them on top like this, and you're gonna do this with some misdirection. You're just gonna say, here, look, I'll kind of spread out the cards like this so you can really see that the cards are getting all shuffled together. And at this point, you just kind of literally move that ace of spades to the top, but it's gonna go unnoticed because you're doing this spreading out action here, which is a lot more visual for the spectator. So they're not gonna remember that you moved cards. So when you do this, now the card will be controlled to the top of the deck. And if you guys are scared of doing that riffle shuffle thing, you guys don't have to do that. You can literally just control the card to the top any way you want to without the spectator handling the cards. So at this point, you're gonna turn the cards back over, facing up, and you're gonna spread through the cards, showing that they're getting shuffled, and you're gonna start doing some riffle shuffles and just maintain that bottom card there on the bottom, or the top card in this case, the ace of spades. So just give it like two riffle shuffles, and when you finish the second riffle shuffle, you're not gonna square it up completely, you're gonna leave it a little bit messed up. The one sleight of hand move that you're gonna do now is called the half pass, which is basically, you're going to take the card here that's on the bottom or the top of the deck, the ace of spades, and you're gonna turn it over under the cover of the rest of the deck. So there's gonna be one card now facing down, and it's going to be their card, the ace of spades. So how you're gonna do this, you're gonna shuffle the cards here and leave that card on the bottom, give it a shuffle, and do a bridge. And then when you are squaring up the cards, what I like to do is use my index finger here. I just kind of push that card and I kind of buckle it like this. And that will allow me to get a pinky break like this underneath. So when I push the card, it's gonna bend. And then that card will kind of bend up on the bottom. So that allows me to get my pinky inside of there. Now I'm gonna start squaring up the cards. And as I do that, I'm going to just simply lower my hand and kind of just let that card turn over with my fingers here under the cover of these cards. And then I'm gonna use the deck and push it back on top of that card. And that card's gonna get turned over just like this. So now there should be one card facing down and it's going to be their card on top. So now after you do this, you should give it at least one or two more riffle shuffles just to seem consistent. Because if you do the half pass move and then stop, it's gonna seem a little bit odd. So just give it like one or two more riffle shuffles and just be sure to keep this card on the bottom and be sure not to flash this card is facing up. So you don't wanna lift up your hands or anything like that. Just make sure you keep that card on the bottom and it should get hidden by all those cards getting riffle shuffled. So you shouldn't really have to worry about that card flashing. So at this point, you're gonna explain the process of the choosing a number. So you're gonna have the spectator think of a number between 1 and 52 and tell them to not name it out loud. Only think of it in their head. Do an example. Just if they say 10, you're gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 cards singly from the top and then turn the cards over so that later we can clearly see how many cards you counted. Now you're going to hand the spectator the deck facing up like this. So now the spectator has the deck here. They're not gonna spread through. They don't even know that there's a card here on the bottom and they're not gonna do anything about that. So they're holding onto the deck and you're gonna tell them to place the cards behind their back. So they're gonna place the cards behind their back. Just pretend that it's behind their back now, but I'll keep it here in the camera's view. And now what you're gonna do next is you're actually gonna set the cards up so that this next part of the trick will work. But the spectator thinks that they're further randomizing the situation, which is what I love about this next part. So you're gonna give the spectator the option to choose this next part if they want to start counting from the top of the deck or the bottom of the deck. No matter what they say, what's gonna happen is you're gonna ask the spectator to turn the cards over so that the ace of spades will now be on the top of the deck. This is what you say if they say top or bottom. So if they say top, then you say, okay, perfect. So take the cards and turn them over so that we start from the top of the face down deck. And that will make sense because obviously you handed the cards to them facing up. So obviously this is the bottom of the deck, so the top of the deck should be here, right? So that will be a perfectly justifiable reason for doing that. Now, if the spectator names bottom, all you say is perfect. So turn the cards over then so you start from the bottom of the deck. Since the cards are behind their back, they're not really gonna remember if it was facing up or facing down, and they'll just think, oh, okay, I'm starting from the other side, which is the bottom. As you can see, no matter what they say, you're just gonna instruct the spectator to turn the cards over, and you need the cards to be facing this direction for the trick to work. You don't want them to be facing this direction. You need them to be facing down here with the ace of spades face up on top. So now the spectator is going to think of a completely random number, and they're gonna count this number on top of the deck one card at a time. So let's say they're thinking of the number 12, for example. They're gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 cards behind their back, and they have no idea that this card is facing up. Now what they're gonna do is take these cards and turn them over, and that right there is the secret of the trick. So as you guys can see, no matter how many cards they count, their card is always just gonna get flipped over, and it's gonna get right underneath their amount of cards. So as you guys can see, I could have counted like 20 cards like this, and it would not have mattered because if I get to the bottom here, this is always going to be the spectator's card. So as you guys can see, it really does not matter how many cards they count. But let's say in this case, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Spectator does this themselves. They turn over the cards. And now they're gonna bring the cards back, and you're gonna take them back and spread out the cards just like this and say, look, you guys counted anywhere and you stop right here at this card. Now you can do two things at this point. You can either end the trick here. You can just flip over that card and that can be the end of it. Or you can do one little extra thing, which I kind of like to do, which is just a nice little convincer. They counted 12 cards, but if you actually look a little bit more closely here, you're only gonna see 11 cards, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Because the spectator's card, which was facing up, actually got counted as one of the cards. And since this card's now face down, it removes one card from this face-up pile. So if you want to make it look like this face-up pile is actually 12, this is how I like to make it look like this has 12 cards inside of it. So I count the cards one at a time. I hold the cards in biddle grip, and I count them one at a time into my hand. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When I get to about the middle of the card, 6 or 7, what I'm gonna do is peel the next card off, and I'm going to hold a pinky break. And then when I'm about to peel off the next card, I'm gonna grab that card with my thumb from the bottom here. I'm gonna grab it like this, boom, as I peel off that next card, like that. And then I can continue counting. And what that will do is it will count this card twice, which will essentially add one card to the pile. So if I do this again, I'll count 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll pick it up. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that will essentially make it look like there's 12 cards here. And then you can just put these cards away and the spectator won't even question that this isn't 12 cards because you just counted them. They even counted these themselves. So there's really no reason to be suspicious in any way. And then you're just gonna reveal, boom, they stopped exactly at their favorite card or their thought of card, whatever you call it. But yeah, that's essentially the entire trick right there. So as you guys can see, it's pretty simple and it's fairly hands-off. The spectator pretty much does all the work for you, which is the best part. All you need to do is take this card and turn it over on the bottom and then just get them to turn it over. And yeah, you're pretty much done. So yeah, that's the trick, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like and also subscribe to the channel if you have not already. So yeah, see you guys from my next one. Bye.